Hello everyone, my name is Bo Gerbrands and welcome to the Voxel Max Getting Started video series. Here we show you how to create your own amazing Voxel models. The goal is to learn the toolset, but also the workflow and artistic choices. As an example, I created this small mushroom house that we will create together. At the end of the video, you will learn how to navigate the scene, how to move and rotate objects, and quickly build your own scene using the Asset Manager. Use the video chapters to rewatch parts of the video. Let's get started. The first time you open Voxel Max, you are greeted by the intro slides. You can skip these and take a look at the assets. As you can see, there are example scenes if you want to take a peek, but also various assets we can choose to start with. For now, let's select the second avatar character, or one you like. By simply pinching with two fingers, we can zoom in and out, using one finger to orbit around the model, and two fingers to pan. Try and get a feel for it. Next, we take a look at the file menu. This might not be the most exciting thing, but it's good to be aware of. The presenter view is to visualize your scene in a nice way. This will be explained in a future video. Moving on, we have more common options like creating a new file, opening recent files, saving manually, duplicating the current file, and sharing the scene, also known as exporting. Then there is the Help Center to watch tutorials or documentation. And the all-important Settings tab to change the configuration of Voxel Max. Lastly, the exit to gallery returns us to the view from the start of the video. Let's take a quick look at the settings. Here you can find rendering and exporting options, accessibility and gesture settings, and presenter view options. I recommend changing any settings to your preferred way of working. Tap outside of the settings view to continue and hold the view cube placed on the top right side. Here are the most commonly used render settings to change while working. For example, changing the view type from perspective to orthographic, or changing shadow settings. If we tap once on the front side of the view cube, our view is aligned with the front side. By swiping on the view cube from right to left, we can rotate the view in 45 degree increments to the right side. This works in any direction. Again, tap once to align with view to selection. We can also quickly change between perspective and orthogonal view by double tapping the view cube. Alright, let's go over the scene overview, also known as the list of objects or the outliner. Select our character and tap the top right icon to go into the scene overview. Select the group named Avatar to go into it. By double tapping the object, we can achieve the same thing or use the up and down arrows located at the top right corner. Next, select the head and move it around on different axes. The color red corresponds to the x-axis, green to the y, and blue to the z-axis. The arrows on screen are called the gizmo. We can also undo the last action by tapping with two fingers, using three fingers to redo. You can also use the undo and redo actions in the top left corner. We can also move multiple objects by using the selection options in the bottom left corner. By selecting expand, we can select multiple objects. Aside from moving objects, we can also rotate by using the colored arches. They correspond to the axes. To deselect objects, use the contract option. To deselect everything, use the new selection option and select nothing in view. Let's do something a bit more fun. Tap the up arrow to go out of the current group. Select the Asset Manager icon at the bottom. Here we can import existing models that come with Voxel Max. With everything deselected, if we select one of the basic primitives, it is added to the scene overview. We can delete this object by selecting the minus button on the top right. Let's go into the Asset Manager again. This time, we want to add the guitar model to our avatar. If you hold the guitar and drag it towards our character, we can see a small sphere pop up. This is the point where the guitar would snap to. Notice how we are still in the Asset Manager and not the scene overview. This is a nice way to start building your scene. We can add one of these blocks and more by tapping multiple blocks. Notice the number of objects that are being added when dragging it into our view. We can move these blocks by using the gizmo, but in this case, aligning them might be more efficient. If we select the align icon in the bottom left and dragging it on the y-axis, it will align with the current selection. Select the Expand Selection option at the bottom left to align blocks to the current selection. By selecting the clone icon and with our current selection, drag it on an axis to clone these blocks. And don't forget to turn cloning off if you want to move blocks around. For fun, I recommend building your scene using the blocks or any other asset pack. Finally, for any tutorials or help, you can go into the file settings and select Help Center to view documentation and tutorials. If you want to learn more about the tools, you can always drag the information icon for more info. Drag it to a tool to watch a short video. See you in the next video, where we will learn how to create small mushrooms. Bye!